Khloe Kardashian has opened up about an incredibly distressing incident that took place in 2015, revealing that a hoaxer created a fake email account to send her a message stating Lamar Odom had died after his overdose. The former basketball player was left in a critical condition after being found unconscious in a Nevada brothel and was in a coma for 4 days before starting what would be a lengthy recovery. Angela Weiss via Getty Images. Khloe Kardashian speaking on the Keeping Up with the Kardashians 10th anniversary special, Khloe said that the ordeal was even made worse when someone sent her the false information while she was traveling to be at her estranged husband's side. "I was screaming," she tells Ryan Seacrest on the TV special. "To think and to go through the motions, as if someone has passed away, is the most traumatic thing to do, and then to know they're really alive, it was too many emotions, I think, for any of us to handle." Kendall Jenner adds that Kim Kardashian texted her to say Lamar had died, revealing that she read the message straight after landing on a flight from Hong Kong to London. "I immediately started sobbing on the plane," she says. "Then I got the next text come through, saying, actually he's okay, he's alive but he's not doing well." Empix Entertainment. Khloe and Lamar married in 2009, so that's why I was so upset, because I wanted to be there to be able to say goodbye. Lamar and Khloe had signed their divorce papers in the weeks before the incident, but when Lamar was hospitalized, lawyers for the Kardashian sister rushed to the courthouse to pause the proceedings. The move allowed Khloe to be involved in medical decisions, and she continued to support him throughout his recovery when he was transferred to a Los Angeles hospital. Lamar later moved into a new home near Khloe's Calabasas residence, but the pair did not resume a romantic relationship and finalized their divorce in December 2016. The Keeping Up with the Kardashians 10th anniversary special airs on Monday 25 September at 9 a.m. and will also be available to watch on Hulu.